I'm Pedro, I'm on the Remix team, and I'm here to show you the new dev server in Remix 118. So let's jump right in. All right, so let's make our project. I'll go ahead and do that with create remix. I'll pick latest, which will be 118, and I'll call our example example. And just to make something a little more realistic, I'm gonna pick the indie stack as our starting point. So that way we'll have a nice app to start out with that we can modify. All right, the app setup is complete. Let's go ahead and go in there. I'm gonna make a Git repository. And one thing I'm gonna do real quick before we spin up the dev server is I'm just gonna make sure that the new dev server is enabled in Remix config. So you can do that by setting the v2 dev flag to true. All right, we're all set. Let's go ahead and run the dev server. All right, so the dev server is running. Let's check out what our app looks like. So here it is. Let's go ahead and log in. I know the default credentials here are rachel@remix.run, and Rachel is cool. All right, so we're in our app, and let's say we're working on this new note form. So let's just make an example note. Example note, some stuff. Great. And let's say that we don't like how this looks right now, and we want to change some things. We want to change this body title here to say description instead. And we also want to change the outline from blue to red, because our designer told us so, right? So let's go ahead and do that. And when we save, you can see that those changes come in immediately. And we still have all of the data from our inputs here, right? We still have the example note text and the some stuff text. If we were doing a full page reload, like we were before with live reload, then we would have lost those inputs. But now we're using hot module replacement, or HMR, and so that lets us preserve the browser state, right? So then here, if I want to change this again, I can go ahead and change this without losing any of that. So let's go ahead and save this note. And let's go make a new note. My fourth note, blob. Okay, so now let's make a change that isn't markup and it's not styles, but it's a server change, right? So these notes here are coming from our server through a loader. So let's go see where that's happening. I think that's in the notes.tsx. Yep. So we're getting these notes from this get node list items call here inside of our loader. And then down here, we're actually rendering out each of these notes. And you'll notice that this is just rendering them out in the order that they came from the server. The server is the one who's deciding how to sort these. So let's go look at that. So if I go into the get note list loader call here, so this is one of the functions that we're calling. And sure enough, we're using Prisma and we're ordering things by updated at descending. So we're gonna get the newest updates at the top and the oldest ones at the bottom. So let's change that to ascending to get the oldest stuff coming up at the top. And let's save that. Did you see how those things moved? Let's just see it one more time. So if I go here and I change this to descending, you'll see first note goes from the top to the bottom. And then if I switch it back to ascending, first note goes back up to the top. How cool is that? Remix is keeping your app up to date, whether you're changing the markup or the styles like we saw earlier with HMR, but it's also keeping your app up to date if you're making changes to your server, like for example here where we're changing our loader. That's really cool. So that's something that we call hot data revalidation. Remix is able to detect that your loader changed and it revalidates the data just for that loader and brings it into your page for you. And again, we're not refreshing the page, we're doing this in a hot update so that we keep all of your inputs preserved. So the new dev server is a huge leap in developer experience for Remix. You don't have to worry about it being code from your server or code in your UI or anything in between. Remix is just keeping all of that stuff fresh. I'm super excited for you to try it out. And if you want to see how to set this up specifically for your project and really get the most out of it, I suggest you watch the next two videos that we have on the dev server that talk about how the dev server works a little under the hood so you can get a better mental model for it, and then how you can migrate your app to the new dev server. All right, I'll see you there.